إن الحمد لله، نحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه، ونعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهدي الله فلا مضل له، ومن يضلل فلا هادي له، ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، له الملك وله الحمد، يحيي ويميت، وهو على كل شيء قدير. هو الله الواحد الأحد الحي الصمد الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. ونشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه، بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح الأمة وكشف الغمة وتركها على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك. فصلوات ربي وسلامه عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. يقول المولى عز وجل في كتاب العظيم بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم: يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون. أما بعد، my dear brothers and sisters in Islam، إن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم، وشر الأمور محدثاتها، وكل محدثة بدعة، وكل بدعة ضلالة، وكل ضلالة في النار. نعوذ بالله سبحانه وتعالى من النار. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, for the last four khutab I did in different places, I was advised myself and my brother and sisters, by the time that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will write it for every one of us to leave this dunya, the moment that we will be alone under the ground with no one with us. And my advice, it's nothing, it's a reminder, but it became very strong from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as you heard, by the earthquake and the flood. This is the best example and the test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's not a punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's alert. And it's better for the believers who spend the time praying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They're not doing anything wrong, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted them as a board, as a shuhada. And this alert for the disbeliever too. Because when we are talking about the last moment in this dunya, when you leave it, and we have the questions, where is the punishment from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? That says no God, wal'iyadhu billah. That's no God. The dunya is just running like that. That's no God. We don't believe in God, wal'iyadhu billah. So this is the alert for the believers and the disbelievers. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us that as a test, and everyone saw that by his own eyes through the media, what else we need from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when we see the masajid empty? When you see in the Jum'ah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it fard on us, still people is not alerting. It's not even leave what they have in the dunya to come for word, for the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إِذَا نُودِيَ لِلصَّلَاةِ مِنْ يَوْمِ الْجُمْعَةِ فَاسْعَوْا إِلَىٰ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ وَذَرُوا الْبَيْعِ. Leave everything behind you. What we saw by our own eyes, people left everything, running left and right, they looking for each other. Nobody care about the other, they running. No father care, or mother, or sister, or anyone, everybody running. And after fact, they come and they search, and they look at each other. Where is my son? Where is my mom? Where is? This is the example of the day of judgment, when we are standing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the people get the book by the right hand, and you go to Jannah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala let all of us among those, they still looking behind, say, where is my father? Where is my mother? Where is my son? Where is my daughter? He's still gonna search. It's exactly example what we are saw today in the media, as we are saying that deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time alerting us by the Quran. If you ignore the book of Allah, you're not in this dunya. You're in different place. You're not in the land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إن الأرض لله يورثها من يشاء من عبادي. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is calling you. يا عبادي الذين آمنوا إن أرضي واسعة فإياي فاعبدون. My earth is so huge, big. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Imagine this small, tiny part of the earth. Alert the whole world. What about إذا زلزلت الأرض زلزالها وأخرجت الأرض أثقالها وقال الإنسان ما لها يومئذ تحدث أخبارها بأن ربك أوحى لها. يومئذ يصدر الناس أشتاتا ليروا أعمالهم فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يرى ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يرى. So what do you think when the whole earth, the whole land of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ended and everybody was run left and right. But the second, Allah take the souls, that's it, done. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala remind all of us all the time in His book. Since we ignore the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we are away from the deen of Allah. We cannot be alert. We cannot even do our prayer because we still think about the dunya and the money and the building which we are seeing by our own eyes. Everything is gone in a second. يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت وتضع كل ذات حمل حملها وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. Time will see it. Everyone will drop the baby. People running left and right thought they are drunk, but they are not. They escape from this moment. We saw it. So what else can alert us? Isn't it time for the disbeliever, before the believer, to understand there is a power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? أَوَلَمْ يَكْفِيهِمْ أَنَّا أَنْزَلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ يُتْلَى عَلَيْهِمْ إِنَّ فِي ذَلِكَ لَرَحْمَةً وَذِكْرَ لِقَوْمٍ يُؤْمِنُونَ. We revealed the book to you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, to reveal it on them, they still don't understand it. Just tell to talk to them. قل كفى بالله بيني وبينكم شهيدا يعلم ما في السماوات والأرض. Just tell them between you and me and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He knows what is the earth and the sky. And it happened. We saw it. What else we need? والذين آمنوا بالباطل أولئك هم الخاسرون. The people who is not believing that, they are the loser. ويستعجلونك بالعذاب. They say, where is the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We cannot see that. ولولا أجل مسمى لجاءهم العذاب. Because everything Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wrote it by timing, they will see it. ولا يأتينهم بغتة وهم لا يشعرون. It will come to them suddenly and they will saw it. يستعجلونك بالعذاب. وإن جهنم لمحيطة بالكافرين. They ask you, where is the punishment? While Jahannam is surrounded them. يوم يغشاهم العذاب من فوقهم من فوقهم. They're gonna come from the top of them and from تحت أرجلهم. Will surround them. This is the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So when the earthquake or the flood come to any place, that's no different between Muslim and non-Muslims. But for us as a believers, we have to be alert. You have to understand the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's truth. He gave you the best Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Muhammad. He gave you the Quran and the Hadith. What else did you need? Why you not scared? Sayyidina Ka'b, one of the tabi'een, he became a Muslim in the time of Umar radiallahu anhu wa ardah, from Yemen. He listened to the Quran, his heart is moving, and he converted to the Islam. And he became one of the knowledgeable person, because he was a Jewish, among the scholars, and he memorized all the Torah and the explanation. And when he entered the Islam, he studied all of that carefully. So when he gave the advice, everybody's listening to him because he collect all the knowledge. But imagine when he passing by Sayyidina Umar ibn al-Khattab radiallahu anhu arda. And Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu arda say, Ka'b, come, alerting me, make me cry.
Tell me about the Akhirah.
And who's asking that? It's not like you saw the earthquake or something. Something's unseen. And he's talk about it. And everybody's scared. The one who's asking, the one the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Ya Umar, لقد أتممت دينك. Your deen, your iman is completed.
Umar, the one he said, if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive everyone and everyone will enter Jannah except one, I thought this one would be the Umar. That's Umar ibn al-Khattab. لو سألت عن العدل, the justice is Umar radiallahu anhu arda. The one the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, I'm getting jealous from Umar when I saw his hur in Ain in the Jannah. That is Umar. And he's asking Ka'b to alert him. So the earthquake and the flood is not alerting any of us. It's not alerting the prince and the kings and the earth and the president. While one of them only can take in care and rebuild the places. From the amount of money they spent of the soccer players to get them back there and they play soccer players. Get all this money. While we try to collect dollars. When I saw the king of Morocco visiting the people in the hospitals, I'm against the way they celebrate and they welcome him. I'm against that. But he's very sick actually. And he got a disease. You know, he's one of the wealthy person on the earth. Among the first 10 people. And he got a disease, very weird. Can be cured and can be remained. But the way he attend the hospitals and visit the people, when I saw the truth of his tears, it's not fake. I cry too. I did. My tears dropped too. Now he feels the pain of the people who are sick in the hospitals or the earthquake attacked them. I saw how he hugged them and talked to them. It's true. Now we return as a human being. Understand who we are. There's no difference between king and the regular person. I saw that yesterday when I saw how he come closer to them and hugged them and he cried. It's a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's a wake up call. No matter who you are, moment will come. Allah will soft your heart. Not like the among the people that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described them in the Holy Quran. Does her heart stone like rock? فهي كالحجارة أو أشد قسوة. More strong than the stones. And the stone sometimes the river come under it. And the water come through. And some of them يهبط من خشية الله drop from the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We have the Quran that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the holy book, لو أنزلنا هذا القرآن على جبل لرأيته خاشعا متصدعا من خشية الله. If we reveal this book, the Quran on the mountain will be dropped from the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, from scaring from the of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we're still not scared. We still think about the dunya. We still think about the money. We still think about our life. Everyone has plan. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala his own plan. When we talk about the death and we leave this dunya, and I said it many times and the last khutab, even here, for how long we can be under the ground alone by ourselves? Allah knows better. Allah a'lam. But when we talk about the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how is the grave will be, this is the best example for you that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, this is from the earth we bring whatever we want to, and from the sky we drop whatever we want. Subhanallah al-Ali al-Azim. He's alerting us. Not even 1 year passed when we saw what happened to Syria and Turkish. And today another example. And Allah alerting the Muslim more than the others. Because we believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We need to be in Jannatillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam mentioned that, he said, "Taqtarib al-sa'a," the hour will getting closer when, Ya Rasulullah, from the sign of the hours, then you see earthquake increased, will be increased. He says so, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَيَقْتَرِبُ الزَّمَانِ The time will be nothing. Today you can travel, you can take the plane from one country to another country through the ocean quick and fast. And he said, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the money will be has no value. You can buy the houses before by a couple of hundred, today is a million. Money has no value. والكاسيات العاريات في الشوارع You see the naked woman in the street صلى الله على محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم We see that وناطحات السحاب You see the building is very high More than 100 floors We saw that رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم is alerting But we are taking everything light We're not thinking ويقتل القتل People killing each others Mainly, father killed the son, son killed the father, mother, daughter. They kill each other. Even among us as the believers. You can come close, inshallah, to make room to your brother. Jazakumullah khair. Fill the gap, inshallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning us, ثم أنتم هؤلاء تقتلون أنفسكم. Today you are killing yourself. Allah give you the land. We all, most of us foreigner, we left our own country for injustice to come here and live in this country. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala he said, Ya ibadiya alladhina amanu inna ardi wasi'a fa'iyyaya fa'budu. Any place you go, just obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know what he said after that? Kullu nafsin dha'iqatul maut thumma ilayna turja'un. Every single soul would taste the death. And you will return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Think about it how you want to return to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Individual, or with your family, or your friend, or your neighbor, or with the people who pray with you all the time. If you are doing best, the best and the great to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, take everything with you to Jannatillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When the person he was going to the Jannah turned behind him and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what you are looking for? My father, my mother, my friend, my, said, take them with you to Jannah. Allah Rahim, Allah has mercy and rahmah, which you don't have among each others. Among each other, we don't have this rahmah. Among each other is the money. Money talk, houses. But we're gonna leave everything. People left it. Tell me, where is the money they put in their houses today when you saw the earthquake or the flood? It's hurt the people who disobey their parents. You saw the man in the middle of the flood, carried the two young boys fighting to save them. Fighting, this is the father. Imagine, he is the father. Why today we are screaming and yelling and talk bad to our parents. Correction. The real earthquake, my dear brothers, the way we deal with each other. The real earthquake that we are telling lies. False witness. Adultery. Lying. Stealing. Talk bad to each other, not watching our tongues, away from the masajid of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not to fast when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you the month of Ramadan, when you're not paying your zakah, if you're not taking care of the poor and need, or the orphan, this is the real earthquake. That's what you are witnessing in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah give whatever He give to the brothers and sisters in Morocco and in Libya. But you, individual, and myself, we will standing, will be the real earthquake in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, shaking from the deeds what we did in our dunya. Asking about your salah, your zakah, how we deal with your parents, How you treat your cats, your kids? How do you grow? Did you teach them anything? It's scary when the son stand in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he ask him. He never teach him anything. It's your duty. It's your duty, brothers, sisters. Allah will ask in all of us what we did for our kids. We need to go together to Jannatillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is alert from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is the best alert. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَاسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ وَلِسَائِرِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, some people, they don't like the way I'm talking regarding the issue when collecting money. The organization around in these days, they are increased. They come all over the messages. They want to collect money. I'm keep repeating for them. At this time, you need to take percentage from what you collect from the masajid, 15 or 10%, because you have some people work for them. Can these people give up at this time only when we have earthquake and flood and say, listen, we're not taking this time any percentage. The money we collect, we're going to send it as it is, because you're collecting during the whole year long. In Ramadan time, in the Eid al-Akbar, in the Qurbani time, during the days, you turn around, that's fine. But this is critical time. You collect a dollar from another and another and another, and you take percentage out of that. I'm against that 100%. Because this is a time, it's alert. One of the leader in Libya who is standing there, you have two. First, Sheikh Mahmoud, the one who was leading the Taraweeh here. He was standing collecting, and what he was so happy about the way they collect. What I, when I saw behind him, some clothes and food is nothing. I'm telling you, wallahi, one of us here can pay that. And he's still happy and he makes dua to the people. And the other, a leader, he's standing screaming at the people who selling the products, triple the price to make money. Even he didn't see what he saw by our own eyes. How is everybody hungry and need the food? Even they raise the price to make money. Even what happened is not alerting the business people who's selling the fruit and the vegetable. They treble the price. He's screaming at them. He said, what else are you going to wake up? Are we a Muslims or by the tongue inheriting the Islam? We became a Muslim and that's it. We pray and we go home. Count the zakah money and that's it. We have duty, brothers. When coming to the critical, we have to stand as a believer, as what we learned from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We learn from him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whatever he has in his house, he gave it away for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look what Abu Bakr did, Uthman, Ali, Umar, Umar ibn Abdul Aziz. What else you want to hear? Look at the story of the Islam. When issue coming, critical, we stand firm as a believers, and this is the last time in our dunya. We have to think about it, not to abuse. So ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala at this time to make it easy on them, inshallah, and make Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soft the heart of the believers, mainly our leaders and the prince and the king and the president. Soft their heart to taking care of those people is better than all of us. They have the money. They have the money. We don't have any. Whoever they have, it's easy for you because you feel the pain. It's whatever you collect is nothing compared to what they have. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala soften their hearts. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help our brother in Libya and Morocco and Turkish and Syria and all the poor in the earth. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect all of them. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala support them by His malaika. Allahumma ghafir lil mu'minina wal mu'minat, al muslimina wal muslimat, al ahya'i minhum wal amwat. Allahumma ashfi maradana wa marad al muslimin, irham mawtana wa mawt al muslimin. La taj'al lana dhanban illa ghafarta, wala maridan illa shafaita, wala mayitan illa rahimta. Allahumma inna nas'aluka al janna wa na'imiha wa na'udhu
أعوذ بك من النار وشرورها لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين وصلى اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين عباد الله رحمني ورحمكم الله إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون اذكروا الله العلي العظيم يذكركم وادعوه يستجب لكم وأقم الصلاة